Hello and welcome. This waving flag animation tutorial will show you how to easily create the animation of a waving flag in Blender, using a simple wind force field and cloth physics simulation. First, create a simple pole for the flag. I will make a simple pole with a thicker base. Be creative in your design and make it as high as you want. After defining the shape, I will add a subdivision surface modifier. This will make the pole pointy. I will activate the smooth shading for the pole. Now, create a plane. This will be the flag. Position the plane in the place where you would like your flag to be. Now, in edit mode, give the plane a flag-like shape. Keep a small distance between the plane and the pole object. In edit mode, select the face of the plane. In the tools menu, click subdivide 6 times. That's enough faces for a smooth simulation. Now, go to the object mode. Click the physics tab. Add a cloth physics modifier and select one of the fabric presets. Now, activate smooth shading in the tools menu. Now, it's time to define the pinning vertices for the flag. On edit mode, select the vertices that will be fixed in their position. In the object data tab, create a new vertex group. Click the Assign button. Now, if you click the Select button, only the grouped vertices will be selected. Check the Pinning checkbox and select the Pinning Vertices group. As you can see, the flag is held in place by the pinning vertices. Now, we have to fix the collision problems between the pole and the flag. Also, the flag's faces should be colliding between themselves. Let's fix this. Go to the cloth collision menu and check the self-collision checkbox. Select the pole and add a collision modifier in the physics tab. Now, as you can see, the flag is colliding with everything, as it should. Let's create the wind simulation. Add a wind force field. Position the wind force field close to the flag and pointing to it. The arrow shows the direction of the wind force. Make the force field bigger and adjust its position. Keep the arrow centralized on the flag. Now, set the strength value to about 180. Set the noise value to 9. Set the flow value to 9. The seed can be any value you want. The yellow rings show the fading distance for the wind force effect. You may notice the animation plays slowly. This happens because the cloth simulation is being calculated. This blue line in the timeline shows the already calculated frames. Once it's done playing once, it can be replayed at a normal frame rate. Here's what a playback looks like with a wind force strength value of 666. Now, attach the flag to the pole. To do this, create a child of constraint for the flag. Set the pole as the target and click the Set Inverse button. Now, when you animate the pole, the flag will follow it. Customize your flag and pole with your own materials and textures. If you want, you can animate the pole to give more motion to the flag. I hope this tutorial was helpful to you. Leave a like and subscribe.